Well, we may have seen a game leaked out early on some retailer sites. Now, this happens a good bit, and it doesn't always mean that this game is coming to the system. However, when so many of these retailers start just putting this out, like several, not just like one. A lot of times if it's one, you're like, eh, maybe. In this case, though, we're talking several. GameStop, Amazon, Gamefly. All of these places listed Batman, the Telltale series, Enemy Within, the newest one, for the Nintendo Switch. Now, we, of course, saw Batman, the original Telltale series, also leaked out by retailers for the Switch. And it seems almost like the Telltale series are going to start moving over to the Switch with something like, of course, the Minecraft Telltale series that went over to the Switch that's coming out soon. It almost seems obvious that they would move these games over, but what's interesting here is Batman has had performance issues even on really powerful computers, so to hear that it's going to the Switch is a little interesting. Now, this, of course, remains a rumor until, well, they officially announce it. I can say, though, working in retail, where I did see a lot of games that were basically told to us by these companies before it was actually announced, that's actually a common thing. You will hear about games working at retail that are put into your computer system before they're officially announced. Call of Duty, the Remastered Collection, or at least Call of Duty 4 Remastered, that was coming out, I knew about well before it was even announced. Like, well before. They asked for our pre-order numbers pretty quickly. So there's a good chance that, yeah, GameStop and these other companies, Gamefly, for example, which doesn't usually post these unless they absolutely know. They seem to be more reliable than GameStop, which is interesting. But these companies that are putting these out, yeah, more than likely, they have heard that this is coming, and they've had to put their pre-order numbers in, and then, of course, they put it up on their site. Amazon has it right now listed, and they have it listed for $40, which is $15 more, I think, than the version on the PS4, which the season pass is $25. But still, if it's coming out physically, that's about right, considering I think, like Walmart, for example, selling the Batman Telltale series physically for $30, that's about $10 more, which falls in line with what we're seeing with Switch games right now, where they generally tend to be about $10 more or so for certain games, like Rime, for example, when it comes out physically. Now, that's not to say every Switch game obviously is more expensive than its counterpart, it's just a trend we have seen with some companies where they were talking about, well, making the Switch version more expensive due to production costs. That probably has to do with the cartridge. I will say, seeing Batman Enemy Within possibly come to the Switch, really the Telltale series, they're actually really good. If you have not played them, it might be worth picking up on Steam just because you don't know if it's actually coming to this system. I will say, it could play pretty well on the Switch if they can get their performance issues figured out. Now, of course, they're also available on the other systems as well right now, but they're not portable. Having this as a portable game would be pretty cool, considering it is a story-driven game, so this would be something you could probably play if you're lounging around or maybe you're in bed or something, and you don't feel like, I guess, sitting in front of a TV and playing it. It's pretty cool to see Batman the Telltale series possibly showing up to the Switch, but we still have to wait to see if it actually gets announced. Right now, all we know is that all the retailers seem to have a listing going up for this game. Is it being announced at Gamescom? Probably not. It'd probably be just a future announcement. Maybe it even makes its way into a Nintendo Direct. Hard to say, but interesting to think about. Thanks for watching, guys. I'll see you next time.